Hey, what's everyone? This is Solomon SK for Whiskey and RPGs, and if you're in the U.S., I hope you guys are having a wonderful Thanksgiving. Excuse me for my voice, I'm a little under the weather, and I got my gin and tonic here, not my whiskey. I'm pretty sure it really doesn't help colds, but that's what I heard, so. Anyways, we got a lot to talk about, and I just want to say thank you for tuning in, and let's just get started. Cheers, everyone. So BDO has many different versions and there's so many different news to cover that I'm just going to put everything under the title of Black Desert Online. The first one comes from MMORPG.com and it's reported that Black Desert Mobile hit 4 million pre-registrations. On a side note, I just noticed on their website that Black Desert Online Mobile is a buy-to-play title for $9.99. It's kind of funny because I automatically assumed it'd be a free-to-play title like pretty much all other mobile MMOs out there, but nope, it's a buy-to-play business model, much like their PC and console counterparts. And I'm kind of curious what their microtransactions are going to contain. But there you have it. Anyways, to celebrate, Pearl Abyss has set up a giveaway on their Facebook page where you have a chance to win a Black Spirits bag of goodies if you comment and like and share. The more times you do that, the more chances of actually winning the giveaway. And the second bit of news comes from MMOculture.com, and this one's kind of a game changer since one of the biggest reasons people play Black Desert Online is because of its combat. Next week on December 4th, a new secession class system will be arriving to the Black Desert Online PC players. The first classes to have this new system will be the Ranger and the Warrior. And basically in this new system, players will now have the choice to make their primary pre-awaken weapons more powerful by sacrificing access to their awaken weapon skills. By doing so, players will gain access to more powerful skills for their pre-awaken weapons that you couldn't get otherwise. Personally, I like this change. I'm not a pro by any means, and having to remember all the different combos for both awaken and pre-awaken weapons across multiple characters is kind of daunting for me. It's still possible to play and remember everything. It does take a while. But wondering why you didn't perform a skill on a Musa because you're playing on a Mewa is something that happens to me way too often. Again, for me anyways. And this isn't really news, but I thought I'd include it anyways because even though a lot of MMO players won't admit it, but it's all about having that special item in-game that no one else can get. It's something that sets you apart from other players. And I guess we kind of all do that in real life too, to some extent, right? So there's an exclusive legendary pack for the PlayStation 4 version of BDO, but it has a $50 price tag on it rather than something that you could earn in game. So take that for what you will. Yeah, Fallout 4, not Fallout 76. Although this is an older game, I thought it would be worth mentioning because I thought Bethesda did something pretty cool, I believe, last week. They released a 3GB update, and one of the items in the Creation Clubs was a new storyline involving you to going back to the GNR location of Fallout 3. Yes, you can see parts of Fallout 3 in the Fallout 4 engine. It comes with legendary armor modeled after some of the textures from the Fallout 3 game, but unfortunately you are only limited to this area of Fallout 3. Can anyone tell me though, if you bring MacCready as your companion while doing this DLC, would it trigger any sort of unique dialogue? I must admit, I'd be a little bit surprised if Bethesda went that extra mile to do so, but maybe I'm just being unfair or maybe I'm just too jaded. Anyways, this next part of the news isn't news in a sense that it's new, but I thought it'd be worth mentioning and something I will definitely keep you guys posted because it's such a huge labor of love and needs a lot of attention. Fallout Miami is going to be a free mod that is the size of a AAA game title in my opinion. The amount of time and effort and the stuff that's being done to make this what feels like an entirely new game is on another level. Again, the labor of love is almost an understatement, just looking at the amount of people involved if you take a look. If you head on over to their YouTube page, you can see that they do a pretty good job at keeping everybody up to date with where they are in the project and even show you what they are putting in the game and how. Certainly using the software to make the game is way over my head. So far, all we really know is that the game will take place around the same time Fallout 4 does, and will consist of plot involving two factions, one being a group of slavers called Sunshine Cove, and another called Nuclear Patriots, who worship pre-war cars. Not that far-fetched considering the Children of Adam. The second Fallout project I wanted to mention is probably on a similar scale to the previous one, and is called Capital Wasteland, A Road to Liberty Project. There's a team of modders that are bringing the world of Fallout 3 in the Fallout 4 engine, but this project did suffer a hiccup earlier this year, mainly because of copyright issues where they couldn't use the Fallout 3 voice assets into this mod. Fortunately, the modders returned to their project back in June, deciding that they're going to revoice all 45,000 lines of dialogue, but will certainly need more help from the Fallout community to achieve this goal. But unfortunately, I haven't heard really much of anything since June. I'm really praying that this game is still being developed, but I can't blame them if the project fell out again. You'll notice that these projects do not have a GoFundMe or a Patreon account, because you're not allowed to be profiting off of other people's property. And the property, again, belonging to Bethesda. And lastly, I wanted to mention Fallout 4 New Vegas. This is another group of modders who are associated with Capital Wasteland folks, and as the title suggests, this one aims to bring the Fallout 4 New Vegas game with the Fallout 4 engine. But this project, I'm a little less confident in. They had the same problems as the folks over at Capital Wasteland did, and the last update was back in December 3rd, 2018, making it an entire year. Again, because the level of work that would be needed to go into these type of projects without any compensation, no one couldn't really blame them for running into issues and leading to the cancellation of these huge endeavors, but if anything changes, you guys will certainly be the first to know. A lot of MMOs and other online games seem to have gone into early access in this week alone, and we just got another one to add to that list. This one is being brought to you by MassivelyOP.com, and the game is called Inferna. It's being described as a final. This is being described as a fantasy MMORPG that is centered around PvE content, and a small group of developers in Germany called Inferna Limited are the people behind it. The game has been developed for about 3 years and will be releasing more content as time goes on. Early access will begin on December 6th, which will last for 1 year, and will be cross-compatible with the game on mobile devices, although early access is only available on the PC. So, first bit of MMO and RPG tidbit news. EverQuest and EverQuest 2 had pre-orders for their next expansions available for a while, but they're finally getting a confirmed release date. This one comes from MassivelyOP.com, and they reported that Daybreak's Twitter said that EverQuest's Torment of the Velius expansion will be released on December 8th, and EverQuest 2 Blood of the Lurklin? I'm sorry, will be released a day earlier on December 17th. The official Twitter handle for Final Fantasy VII Remake has released new images and a blog post from their developers, in case you guys are absolutely need to gobble everything that is Final Fantasy VII, and or Final Fantasy VII Remake. I'll definitely post the link to this site in the description below. The team behind Ashes of Creation released their transcript of their live stream from the 22nd. They went over all the various aspects of Siege Warfare and the upcoming alpha testing. But be warned, the comment section are a bit salty because the accusations of why they're not working on the MMO. But I'll let you be the judge of that. Sorry, I forgot. But at least they're giving you a bear mount. That should help ease the salt, right? And this one comes from MMORPG.com, and Warhammer Odyssey released a new trailer showcasing a large city that will be one of, if not the main hub of the game. I'm not gonna lie, I had no idea what this game was because I'm pretty sure their PC MMORPG title went offline this year or a few years ago. Different MMORPG, but same Warhammer name. So I looked it up, and it's another MMORPG for the mobile device. And just real quick, Red Dead Redemption 2 and Red Dead Redemption Online with it will be arriving on Steam on December 5th with hopefully all the bug fixes. I normally wouldn't put a title like this in tidbits because, one, my own personal biases of looking very forward to this game, but two, it's one of the bigger, more well-known MMO titles in development. But Air is going into open beta soon for the Southeast Asian market. MassivelyOP.com points out that the game is being pushed because Asiasoft, or Playpark, had very disappointing third quarter profits where it didn't even cover its losses for the same quarter, which means that the publisher is quote-unquote effectively hinging its future on the success of this MMO. Still waiting for a Western release, but I'm still super hopeful we'll get that announcement next year in 2020. Hey guys, I just want to thank you for tuning in. Again, my name is Solomon SK, and you're tuning into Whiskey and RPGs. Thank you very much, and I will see you guys next time. Cheers.